See, I've always liked Asus's ZenBook OLED laptops, and now this is here. This is the new Asus ZenBook 14 OLED for 2023, and this is a premium work laptop with some really good specs. Look, I'll talk about everything, but the biggest new upgrade in the new ZenBook 14 OLED is that this brings the new Ryzen 7000 series chipsets. The variant we have is powered by the new Ryzen 7 7730U processor, which is based on the power-efficient 7nm architecture and has 8 cores, 16 threads, a clock speed of 4.5 GHz, and an 8-core Radeon GPU. The RAM is 16GB LPDDR4X and the SSD is a 512GB Gen 3 SSD. Now, I know you're probably wondering, why no LPDDR5 RAM or Gen 4 SSD? Look, I think Asus has compromised on the storage and RAM a bit to bring the more powerful Ryzen 7000 series processor. And Windows laptops in this price range are generally powered by the Core i7-1260P or the 1255U, and the Ryzen 7730U does compete with them very well. I mean, it does better in Passmark and Geekbench single core score, while the Intel chipsets do better in the other benchmarks. However, there is the added advantage of AMD chipsets being more power efficient and bringing better graphics performance. I mean, here's a comparison of the 3D Mark scores of the Iris Xe graphics on the 1260p versus the Radeon graphics on this laptop, and you can see the difference it brings. As for the real-world performance, this thing is a powerhouse. Using this as an everyday work laptop is just really, really good. It's speedy, super responsive, and breezes through everything. I mean, with 12 browser tabs open, with 4 of them playing 4K videos and apps like Photoshop, Slack, Steam, and MS Word open in the background, the laptop did not slow down at all. The laptop also didn't heat up during any of these tasks. To give you a better idea, running Photoshop on this with multiple layers and whatnot does not slow it down. It's just very smooth to use. Now, thanks to the 8-core GPU, even some casual gaming is fine. For example, you get an FPS of around 120 in CSGO at low settings on 1080p. The thermals on the laptop are also good. So there's one fan and one heat pipe in this laptop, and there's no thermal throttling or anything. But we did notice that the fans, when launching an intensive app, don't ramp up right away. It's only when the CPU would climb to 92, 93 degrees Celsius that the fans would ramp up to full speed. Now, once the fans go full speed, the laptop starts cooling down very quickly, and that is when running benchmarks. In day-to-day usage, the laptop is generally very cool and there's no issues. As for upgradability, there are two things in this laptop that you can upgrade. There's obviously the SSD and the Wi-Fi card. I mean, there's no extra M.2 slot, so if you are upgrading your storage, you'll need to replace the existing drive with a new one. The RAM, on the other hand, is soldered, but I think 16 gigs of RAM should be enough for most people. Anyway, apart from the new Ryzen processor, the biggest highlight of ZenBook OLEDs have been its OLED displays. I mean, it's right there in the name, ZenBook 14 OLED. This has a 14-inch OLED panel with a high 2.8K resolution, 90Hz refresh rate, 0.2ms response time, 100% DCI-P3 HDR. Yeah, this display is awesome. I mean, it looks absolutely fantastic whether you're watching 4K HDR videos or just browsing the web, especially with the narrow bezels all around. The viewing angles are great too, and everything feels just super smooth thanks to the high refresh rate. The tall aspect ratio also makes working on this laptop really good, as there's always more content on the screen. Plus, this screen is bright with a maximum rated brightness of 600 nits. Now, the screen is a bit reflective, but other than that, this is just a gorgeous OLED panel. And like the speakers here are also very good. Yes, the speakers here are bottom-fighting speakers, but they get very loud, and even with bass-heavy soundtracks, the output doesn't get distorted. There's also Dolby Atmos support, and the sound overall is crisp, clear, and well-balanced, almost perfect for movies and songs. The design of the laptop remains quintessentially ZenBook, and that means premium, thin and lightweight, but there are some changes from the last gen. The lid has the new Asus Arrow logo and a small Asus ZenBook branding at the bottom, and it's all very minimal and premium. Now, Asus does mention an anti-fingerprint coating on this, but it still managed to attract a lot of fingerprints that are honestly tough to clean. The sides feature the ports. The right has most of them, a couple of USB-C ports with support for PD charging, DisplayPort, and data transfer. There's also HDMI 2.1, 3.5mm jack, and a microSD slot. The right has a fast USB-A port along with ventilation for the fan, and there's some more ventilation on the bottom along with the large rubber feet. Apart from this, the entire body is made of magnesium aluminium alloy, and it all feels solid, and there's also military-grade certification for durability. Now, there is some Manaflex on the keyboard, but other than that, it's all good. The hinge here is Asus's Ergo Lift hinge, which lifts up the keyboard like this for better airflow. I also like the concentric circle element on the hinge, and the laptop does open up with one hand. And like most ZenBooks, this is very portable. It's sleek from the sides and weighs around 1.39 kg. Moving to the keyboard, the typing experience on this laptop is a lot of fun. It has 1.4 mm of key travel, but it feels much more substantial. The keys are also well-spaced, super responsive, and offer great tactile feedback. And the bar button here has been shifted left to the delete key so that you don't accidentally hit it. And this also has the fingerprint scanner built in. The trackpad is solid too. It has a glass surface which is smooth to the touch and resists fingerprints. And the tracking is accurate, and using gestures just feels natural and fluid on this. The trackpad also has Asus's number pad integrated. So I can long press on the number pad icon and this pops right up. I can also open the calculator app from this icon and just start doing numbers. The webcam is a 1080p one and it's actually better than what you get on most laptops, so brownie points to Asus for this. And the mic is also very good. In fact, you get these different modes for the mic which should be useful during meetings. The battery is a 75-watt-hour unit and it comes with a 65-watt USB-C PD charger. Now the battery life is really good. In our testing, a regular day of web browsing, document editing, media consumption will give you about 10 to 11 hours of usage, which I think is really good. Plus you can fast charge the laptop. It goes to 60% in only 45 minutes with the 65-watt charger, which I think is very fast. On the connectivity front, there's Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5. The software here is Windows 11 and you get some handy Asus apps like the My Asus app, but there's also third-party apps like Alexa integrated and also McAfee, which I'm not a fan of. Let's talk about the pricing now. The ZenBook 14 OLED starts at ₹89,990 in India and the variant we have costs ₹104,990. Now at this price, you kind of expect a premium high-end laptop, right? And this is a premium high-end laptop. See, the design is premium and minimal, the display is absolutely fantastic, and the battery life, the multimedia experience are big positives. Now, Asus has used an LPDDR4X RAM and Gen 3 SSD to bring the Ryzen 7000 series processor, but the performance is really good, so I'm not complaining. Anyway, ZenBooks are always very popular, so what do you think about this new ZenBook 14 OLED? Comment down below.